Hello friends, we will discuss one small topic today, that is the determination of edge parameters of BJT using graphical method. In this particular topic, we will see how to determine the edge parameters of BJT using the output characteristics and input characteristics of BJT. If you remember, the edge parameters of BJT, these are defined by VBE is equal to HIE into, that is, IB plus HRE into VCE, and output current collector current is equal to HFE IB plus HOE into VCE. If you draw the circuit, it's something like this. We have common ammeter configuration. This is IB, this is IC, this is voltage VCE, this is voltage VBE. And these are the relationship between the voltages of the voltages and currents of the BJT. Fine. But for small signal variations, I can define, that is, for small signal variations, you can define these parameters like this. HIE is equal to the variation in VBE with respect to variation in IB. If you differentiate it, you will get this, provided this is constant. Provided this VCE is fixed. When this is fixed, if you differentiate it this with respect to this, you will get HIE. Provided this is a constant, fixed. It is a fixed or constant, you can say. Fine. When this is constant, you will get this relationship. Similarly, I can write HRE is equal to differentiate this with respect to this, but when this should be constant. So, variation in VBE with respect to variation in VCE, provided IBE is, that is, base current is constant. And this is how I can define these parameters also. HFE, I can differentiate IC with respect to IB, that is, derivation of IC with respect to IB. When this is constant, it becomes zero. VCE is constant. Similarly, I can define HOE equal to the derivative of IC with respect to VCE, provided this is constant, that is, base current is constant. Fine. So I can define the parameters of BJT. Now see it carefully. If you see this HIE, you can see these parameters HIE and HRC. I have relationship between VBE, IB and VCE. See this characteristic carefully. This is input characteristic. I have IB, I have VBE, I have IB, I have VBE and I have VCE. You can see the characteristics of BJT. So from the characteristics, you have the variation of base current with respect to the base to emitter voltage and VCE. So I can determine these two parameters using input characteristics. So HIE and this can be determined, these two can be determined by using what? By using input characteristics. That is, by using input characteristics. Fine. Why I am repeating? I have relationship between VB, IB and VC. I have relationship between VB, IB and VC. That's it. So I can determine HIE and HRE. We will see the procedure. Fine. Similarly, you see that this case, I have the collector current which is function of base current VC. Here I have the base currents here, and this is the collector current. So the relationship between collector current, base current, VC, relationship between collector current, base current and VC is given by output characteristics. So this means I can determine these two parameters using what? These can be determined by using what? By using output characteristics. So by using output characteristics, I can determine this and this. That's it. Now we will see how to determine that one by one. This topic can be, there can be one objective type question in gate, maybe one mark question. There can be objective type question in engineering services. And there was question in engineering services mains as well, the method of determination of H parameters using graphical techniques or graphical methods. So let us see that. Now let us see how to determine these parameters one by one. Let us take first HIE. For determination of HIE, VCE has to be constant. So when VCE is constant, you can select any of these curves. If you select this curve, so VCE has to be constant. So I keep this as constant. And for small signal variation, remember, I can approximate these expressions. When it is small signal variation, this is approximately equal to delta VBE. I'll rewrite it like this. That is delta VBE by delta IB, delta IB for particular value of VCE, that is constant. And so on. This can be written like delta VBE by delta VCE when IB is constant. What is the meaning of this subscript? When it is small, it is pure AC. When it is this, it is combination of two. That is a combination means AC and DC. So, right? So suppose I take small variation in VB. So I take Q point for this particular voltage and across this Q point, this is Q point, I take the variations in voltage VBE. I am considering small signal variation. So it means variation in the signals is very small. Voltage VC is varying over a very small range where this characteristics is almost linear. For this variation, you will find the corresponding variation in the base current like this. I repeat, please understand. VC is constant. So I take particular curve. For this particular curve, VC is constant. For this curve, it is VCE2 for every point. So when VC is constant, I take variation in VB. I take this variation in VB. VB here is varying from VBE1 to VBE2. So this much variation is nothing but delta VBE. Fine. Similarly, this much variation from here to here is delta IB. Fine. So for a particular curve where VC is fixed value, I take small variation in VBE, that is from VBE1 to VBE2. So that is the portion of the characteristic. The corresponding change in IB will be from IB1 to IB2. So this is projected here, this is projected here, and there is corresponding base currents. Fine. So I can write HIE. So first we are determining this. So HIE is equal to nothing but IB, that is what? That is VBE1, or I'll say VBE2 minus VBE1 by IB2 minus IB1. So this is how we can determine the input impedance of the BJT using input characteristic. Fine. So by taking the small variations in VBE, I have corresponding variations in IB, and these two variations, this and this, can be used for determination of input impedance. Fine. Now let us take this case. So I hope funda is clear. Here HRE is variation in VB with respect to variation in VC, IB is constant. So in this case, we will be taking IB as constant. So I will not vary IB. So I will take particular value of IB. Maybe I'll just redraw it. Maybe these are the characteristics, right? So here, say this is the Q point. This is the Q point. And corresponding to this, we take particular value of the base current that is constant, IBQ. When IBQ is constant, you can see, you draw this, you locate this point and you locate this point. So these are the points corresponding to this IBQ. So you take any two, for small variation, I can take, say, these two points, because I don't need to have multiple points. So corresponding to this constant value of IBQ, I have VCE1 and VCE2, and corresponding to this, we have two value of base to emitter voltage. Please understand, in this case, I have taken constant base current. When base current is constant, corresponding to this base current, I have two values of VCE, VCE1 and VCE2, and corresponding to these two values of VCE, I have two values of base to emitter voltage. So when IB is constant, so you can write, when IB is constant for this particular value of the base current, what is delta VBE? I can write that is delta VBE 2 minus delta VBE 1 divided by what? Divided by variation in this. So that is, I'll not say delta. This is VBE 2 minus VBE. That difference is delta. So that is equal to VCE 2 minus VCE 1. So this is your HRE. So from the input characteristics, we can determine the input impedance of BJT and reverse voltage gain of BJT. I hope the concept is clear. Now let us see how to determine the next two parameters, that is output admittance and the forward current gain. HFE stands for forward current gain of BJT, because it is the ratio of output current to input current. HOE is the ratio of output current to the output voltage. So this is called output admittance. Fine. So now I will go for the output characteristics of BJT. Why? Because output characteristic gives me the relation, that gives me the relationship between IC, IB and VCE. You can see IC, IB and VCE. Fine. Let us see this. This can be just like what we discussed earlier. For small signal variation, this partial derivative can be replaced by these variation. Fine. Like this. Fine. So, but VCE has to be constant. That means I have to select particular value of VCE. Suppose you take any value. This is your choice. Maybe this is the operating point. So I take any value of ICE, that is ICEQ, and corresponding to this, you take variations in the collector current and the base current. Please see carefully. I have taken VCE for a, I have taken particular value of VCE, and I take corresponding variation, the variation corresponding to this in base current as well as collector current. This is IC1, this is IC2. Please see. For this particular voltage, I have drawn vertical line. For this vertical line, VCE is constant everywhere. So, but for this particular value of VCE, I have these base currents. There will be, of course, different base currents, but we will take small, the characteristics have, which are having small gap, because it is small signal variation. Fine. So, this gives HFE equal to what will be delta IC that is IC2 minus IC1 divided by what will be corresponding change in base current, that is IB2 minus IB1. That's so simple, but important to understand. Now, let us take next. Here base current is constant. I take variation IC with respect to VCE. So let us see that variation. I will be taking particular characteristic which correspond to fixed value of the base current. Say I take this value. Fine. And for this particular case, we take two values of the voltage VCE. So first say it is VCE1, it is VCE2, and if you take, although there is very small variation in the collector current for these corresponding values of VCE, so this is IC1 and this is IC2, there is very small variation here to here. Fine. So HO is will be equal to what? That is IC2 minus IC1. I repeat, for this particular characteristic, base current is equal to IB2 for every point on this curve. So base current is constant. If base current is constant for this characteristic, I take two values of VCE. Small variation between VCE. There should be small gap between VCE1 and VCE2. And if you draw the locate these points on this characteristic of constant IB, you get two points, and corresponding to these two points, I have the collector current IC1 and IC2, even though there is very small change in the collector current. So I have HOE equal to IC2 minus IC1 divided by VCE2 minus VCE1. Fine. There is another important point to be noted here. Ideally, there is increase in the collector current with the base current, with VC. Base current is constant. So there is a slight slope. That is because of an effect known as early effect. You can see my video based on early effect on BJT. But that slope is because of the early effect. And that early effect gives rise to this output admittance. This variation is very small. So output admittance is very small. If output admittance is very small, the reverse of admittance is impedance. So I'll say output impedance of BJT is very large. Why? Because if admittance is small, impedance is reverse of the admittance, so impedance will be large. So output impedance of BJT is considered to be very large. So we take, ideally, please see it carefully, ideally what do we get? Ideally HOE is zero, therefore the output impedance, which is just reverse of this, is 1/0, that is equal to infinite. The output impedance of BJT is ideally infinite. This characteristic is ideally flat. There is no slope in this. That slope arises because of early effect. So I'll say output impedance of the BJT arises because of the early effect. Fine. Otherwise, of course, we have determined all the parameters of BJT using the graphical technique. So we know these characteristics can be determined in laboratory. We can draw these characteristics by taking different values of these. So all the H parameters of BJT can be determined experimentally. That is one point. H parameters can be determined experimentally. Number one. Number two. H parameters are sensitive to variations in IC, variations in voltage VCE, variations in base current, because these are functions of these we can say quantities. Fine.
So H parameters are functions of temperature, voltage, biasing signals, you can say IC, VC and so on. Fine. So try to remember these points. These are important points from objective type questions point of view specially. There are small numericals. Suppose you are given output characteristics and they mention these points. So finding out the value of the parameter is not a task. That's very easy task, I'll say. Fine. So just remember all these points. So just wait for my next video to come. Thank you very much for watching the video.